Hi guys, I'm Dr. Anuj, consultant dermatologist and a certified hair transplant surgeon from New Delhi. So today we are going to discuss certain facts and myths about hair transplant. First is more number of grafts a better thing? Now to answer this, I would just try to explain you a little more in detail. So say there is a clinic X offering you 4,000 grafts at a certain price. You go to another clinic, they say that we'll give you 4,500 grafts for the same price. So you being as a consumer, you would prefer the clinic B, which is offering you more number of grafts, because for you, more the number of grafts, better are the results. Now, let me just take you inside. Number one is the requirement. What exactly is your requirement? Second is, have they taken your future into the consideration? Because it's not about just the number of grafts. We have to plan your future as well. Whether your, say, if you plan a transplant after 10 years, whether your donor area would be sufficient enough to do another transplant after 10 years when you lose your existing hair. Third is, whatever they are committing, whether they are actually doing that. Because to be very practical, you are not going to count the number of grafts. So that is another thing which you should take care of. Number four is, it's not a game of numbers. Because whatever grafts we are going to take out from the back of your scalp, they are not going to grow back there. It's basically transferring of roots. It's transferring of roots from the back of your scalp to the front. So it has to be planned meticulously, wherein we preserve the donor area as well, and we give that sort of density in the recipient area that your scalp looks full. Point two is, there's a very minimal role for the doctor in the procedure. Most of the procedure is performed by the technicians. Well, this is again completely false, because in good centers where the doctor is a qualified doctor and he himself is doing the majority of the procedure, you should be aware, in FUE technique, the doctor is performing the extraction, the doctor is designing your hair, he is making the slits in which the grafts are going to be finely inserted, and that is a very important part of the procedure, because your angle, density, direction, everything is decided in that step. But on the contrary, there are clinics where doctor is just a face and the entire procedure is being performed by the technicians. So I would say that you have a detailed consultation with your doctor. What exactly is he going to do? Yes, according to ISHRS guidelines also, the implantation can be and should be performed by the technicians, because if a single guy, say if a doctor says that I'll do your entire procedure, then there is a factor, a fatigue factor as well. If we start doing your procedure, if we start extracting your grafts, if we start implanting your grafts, if we do everything, then definitely the efficacy of the procedure will suffer. So it's a teamwork where there are different roles assigned to different people. So definitely doctor plays a major role. He sets the foundation and it decides the final outcome of your procedure. Third is, why there are certain clinics who are charging a higher price for the same amount of work. I would say there are a lot of factors involved in that, starting with the manpower, starting with the, I would say the second factor would be the infrastructure, the facilities you are getting there, the reviews, the technique. There are a lot of things which come and decide the price. So if there is, say, unqualified doctor, or I would say a doctor who is not eligible to do a transplant with a few technicians, one or two technicians, they might even do your procedure at a cost which you can't even dream of. But if you are getting a procedure done in a proper, with a proper facilities, with proper infrastructure, then definitely there is a cost attached to it, and that is what is being charged to you. So it's not like there are people who are charging 40,000, there are people who are charging 3 lakh rupees for the same procedure. It depends on the quality. Fourth is, where exactly the results can go wrong. So why you should choose a good surgeon? So if I go into the details, there are certain steps of hair transplant, starting with the hair marking, the hairline marking. Second is the anesthesia. Third is extraction. Then fourth is the preservation of grafts, slit making, then the implantation. So every step, there are certain things that you should take care of. Otherwise, the results are going to suffer. When I talk about hairline designing, then it should not be asymmetrical. When I talk about the slit making or the hair designing, then the slit should be at the desired depth. It should not be too deep. It should not be too superficial. The slit designing determines your density, determines your direction, it determines your angle. In fact, it's a very important part of the procedure. When it comes to extraction, yes, the transaction rate should be minimal. When it comes to preservation of grafts, the grafts should be preserved at a required temperature so that they are not damaged. During implantation, what we follow the no root, no touch technique, or rather what we call it here as the deaf touch technique, wherein we hold the graft from the top and we don't crush the roots while inserting. So every step has certain things which you should take care of. Fifth is why it is called an art. Well, it's a normal procedure. People would perceive it as a very simple procedure which anyone can do. But tactically, technically speaking, it is an art where in your designing of your hairline, your designing of your slits, planning of the procedure, like your supply is limited, your demand is huge. Where exactly are you placing the grafts so that you are giving the best outcome? All this is an art. Innovating how your result is going to appear after 6 months. So it all comes with experience. It is not just a procedure. Sixth is, say you get your procedure done at a cheaper cost or with an unqualified person or a team of technicians. See, it's an aesthetic procedure. You are getting it done not because you are sick. You are getting it done because you want to look even better. So the scope of side effects, the scope of complications during this procedure is, I would say, absolutely zero. So if you get any side effects, if you get any complications, you would always regret the decision you took. So I would suggest that choose your doctor, choose your surgeon, choose your center very wisely. Look for the results, look for the reviews, meet your doctor, have a detailed consultation, get your procedure well planned in advance, and then go ahead. Just looking for the cost or just looking for the number of grafts and going in for the procedure is not right. So if you have any other queries, you can get in touch with me. Thank you.